Hey everyone and welcome to this tutorial. Today I will be showing you how to make an ocean toon shader in Maya. Now this is something that I was going through the internet, YouTube videos, forums, and I was trying to find an answer to it, but I couldn't find anything. And I'm guessing that you're here because you're having the same issue. Well, I found the answer, or at least I think I found the basics, and I will take it from there. And this is what I will be showing you today. But before I start with the tutorial, let's see a bit of pictures that I found on internet that I liked it. You see, I've tried this shader in Unity and I really like the results. I'm not gonna lie, I love the results, but nothing in Maya. So today I tried to create this shader and I think I found something. So let's say that, I'm guessing that everyone at least a bit played something similar to that type of games. So you can get all this variation of we can see as on the ocean. I really like this type of oceans, so I will try to make this one. So with that being said, let me show you what I have got before we start the actual tutorial, just to know, to have an idea of what you're getting. So both are animated shaders. I have made two different types because I was trying a lot to find something, and I think I like this one more. Let me show you what they look like when they're moving around. You see this one, I made it very fast, but you still get results. If it was slower, it would look like this. I kind of like both, but my favorite is this one. With that being said, let's jump into the actual tutorial. First thing first, we need to create a plane. This is where we're gonna apply our material and create our shader. For some reason I get the wrong axis, which I fixed it, but just like to go back to it. So now we have the plane, we need to assign a material. So right click, assign new material, go to Arnold and eye standard surface. Go here. Now the thing is that if you have worked with oceans, water and so on, usually a lot of you will go present and just apply the, what is the water? Deep water or clear water, and it will give you something where the coloring change, transmission is very high and so on. This is not how it's gonna work, because this is not a realistic shader, so we want it to be more cartoonish, stylized, and so on. So what we're gonna do is, we go to here to base, and on the color, we click on the box. Now, you see all these lines over here? I found on the forums where people recommended to use textures. And yeah, it's possible to like, go on Photoshop, paint something you like, and then apply it. But what if you don't know how to paint, or you're very, you know, not very good? I mean, I'm not perfect with painting, so I will spend more time in creating that than actually making it in Maya. And I will show you, it's about 12 steps really, and they're really fast. So first thing first, as you can see here, all these lines, if you decide not to paint it, then you have to think about how you can actually create it. So you can see here that we had a lot of fractal noise, simplex noise, Brownian and volume noise, and all these things kind of having the same look in a way. So in my theory, I thought that if I choose any of them, because they have a color settings there where you can apply colors, it will work. Unfortunately, it didn't work everywhere. Where I found it working, it's I applied noise. So of course it's black and white, but it's not gonna be like that. That doesn't look very nice, no matter what I do, it just doesn't look okay. You want these kind of lines around, right? And this is very circle. So what you have to do is go to the noise type here, and on the box, go to space time. Once you select that, all you have to do is just play with the attributes, really. So for my attributes, for example, I have put the threshold or to -182, the attribute to 6. Oops, 6. This is because I want this blackish to be the coloring. As you can see here, we have these lines. You get them later. Those things, they're gonna be separated from blue and white color. So you need to make it clear. So this grayish, let's say, coloring, I'll show you from what I've got. The ocean does move a bit, right? It might have a wave, it might have something. So you need to like connect and disconnect the waves or wherever is that line, right? And this is what happens with a gray coloring. So once you get that, let's go back to it. I've changed that. I'm gonna change my radio to 0.455. Radio frequency to 176. Depth map, I will leave it as it is. And time, now time is, as you can see, it's moving, right? That's the animation. If you go to frame 1, and you keyed, but you're not gonna key it with pressing S. No, you need to go where it says time and make a right click, set a key, the very first. And I will go to 200 frame and change it to 10. I don't want it very fast to go. Let's say that it's not windy. 700, and let's see what happens. Then again, I need to set a key. That means that it locks. First key and last key, and in between is gonna be the animation. So let's start from the beginning and let's see what we got. It's a bit fast. Let's change it to 45. Then again, you need to set a key to lock the new changes. Frame 1 and that's better. I will change the depth to 5. And then I will change the frequencies to 11.89. Let's see what we get. We can go with 10. You see, the higher you go, the smaller stuff you have. So it's all about how you play with it and the look you want. I'm just showing you how you can play around with it, really. So I will stick with that. Yeah, that will work. When we finish with everything and you're happy with the movements and what you're getting, then you need to apply the color, right? What I was doing at the beginning, because my theory said go to color balance, it's not gonna work there. You can try it yourself, but you're not gonna get the results. At least I didn't get them. What you have to do is to go to effects, color remap, and press insert. You see now everything changed. Movements and everything, it creates and connects, disconnect. It's like raindrops, really. You can literally create raindrops this way. So black and white, that's the colors you're gonna change. So I'm gonna make the black as in white, and my white is going to be, now I have already played with the previous color, so you see all my color maps are here, so I'm gonna go with this one. And so you closer you go to white, you see how smaller it becomes. So it depends on the look you want, really. I'm not gonna tell you what's right and what's wrong in that case. I will create a third color, which is going to be slight lighter than the previous. So this one here doesn't really look nice. It looks horrible. But you already get in the idea of what it's going to be. Next thing that I changed is the U wave, which I made it 0.091, V wave, which is 0.201, noise left it as it is, and noise frag as it is. Last thing I've changed is the type. I use this one, Turton Ramp, but I will show you what the rest looks like so you have an idea. That could work. That could also work. So here it is, the second thing. It's not bad. You just play around with it just to get a better. But to go backwards of what I've done is that I went ocean, let's see the radial, let's see the silk raw box, UV, forkhorn ramp, and the one that I used. Slide. And there you have it. So this is the two that I've worked before. This is the one we have made right now. You have an idea how it works and you can play around and get much better. So if you play more till you get your results, you can get something like that or something even better. I hope you found this video very helpful. I hope you understood how the Toon shader for water works. And if you like the video, please do subscribe so you don't miss any more videos that I'm gonna upload with a lot of different or stuff you might not find on the internet. Thank you very much. Bye bye.